part 5 from the series overview about tape recorder circuits in my book Schematics to Audio Amplifiers and Loudspeaker Boxes, meant for hobbyists that want to do experiments with audio, on page 019, tape recorder and playback circuits. And what I've explained in the earlier videos is also here. The fundamentals from how to record something on an electromagnetic tape, with the functions here. I've explained that in the first video from the series. Important to know, and that's what I've also explained in the first videos, that we have a mixed signal consisting of the bias signal and the audio signal, both led to the record head, also playback head, but in the record function these two signals are mixed to get a proper record without any distortion. This is interesting for perhaps shielded wire and static charge. You must use shielded wire to the tape heads because they are at least the erase head is in resonance, and the shielded wire has also a certain capacitance, and that plays a role to get the erase head to the right erase frequency and to its resonance, because the wiring acts as a capacitor. Anyway, that's all in this book. So, more or less the same, my experiment that I've explained earlier, the BIAS oscillator circuit, the different properties from the tape heads, the preamplifier for an electromagnetic tape head, can also be used for other purposes, no problem, everywhere where you want to receive a signal on, say, 15 kilohertz or so, you can use this electromagnetic signal, you can use this as a preamplifier. Of course, due to all the caps, the frequency band will be limited, but anyway, also a good experimental circuit for other purposes. And here again, the overview that was showed in the first video from the series. I hope you enjoyed it. I did my best to explain it as good as possible, but the experiment is the best way to teach, to educate yourself, to get the right experience, knowledge, etc. And that's also the aim for my YouTube channel.